I think the current landscape of inequality that we're looking at in terms of housing, access to healthcare, education, criminalization, have been deeply shaped by the history of redlining.
There are people who have been hurt, generations of people who have been hurt by lines on a map.